In January 2020, 600 Italian officers conducted a major raid in Sicily, arresting 94 alleged members of the notorious Cosa Nostra Mafia, suspected of a multi-million euro fraud. The legendary Sicilian Mafia group is accused of having received more than 10 million euros of fraudulent subsidies through the European Union's Common Agricultural Policy, a scheme they managed to pull off by stealing land from local farmers.
Gli indagati hanno falsamente esibito in un arco temporale che va dal 2012 ad oggi la stessa titolarità.
And this isn't an isolated case. Stories of land theft undertaken to profit from EU money have emerged across Europe.
As far as the eye can see, everywhere from here to there, it all belongs to the Tybalt family now. They have 170 hectares. They got all that and I got nothing.
And the corruption doesn't end there. An investigation published by the New York Times revealed politicians are selling or renting state-owned land to cronies, enabling them to milk the system.
In Felschut, the village home to Conservative Prime Minister Viktor Orban, the mayor and his family control some 1,500 hectares, while local farmers have been overlooked.
So how are payments designed to stabilize prices and boost food production ending up in the hands of violent mafias and corrupt politicians across the continent? This is the story of the European Union's System Error. The European Union's Common Agricultural Policy is a subsidies program that was created after World War II to ramp up food production in countries ravaged by conflict. Over time, it became a critical foundation in creating the modern European Union. Today, the 28-country bloc pays out roughly $65 billion in farm subsidies every year.
After the Second World War, people were starving, they suffered under hunger, and one of the key projects of the European Union at that time in the 50s was to increase the production of food.
The purpose of this policy was to increase productivity, to raise the incomes of the rural population, of the agricultural producers, that is, and to ensure that there was a sufficient supply of food.
But in the early 1990s, something changed. The cap was adjusted so that subsidies were no longer based on the amount of food produced, but on the size of the land that was owned. Mafia members would rent land for 36 euros an hectare and could claim between 800 and 1300 euros an hectare in subsidies. Even super wealthy landowners like the Queen of England and a Saudi prince were suddenly collecting EU cash.
The agricultural policy at the EU level have a number of problems. The way the funds are allocated is obviously at the national level, even if there is quite a lot of red tape at the European level, but the national agencies are the one where normally you find the corruption.
But even before mafias had begun exploiting the system, another problem was already taking root. In 2004, several former Soviet countries entered the EU and became eligible for subsidies. But in these former communist countries, the land was not owned by farmers themselves, but by the state.
What happened with the fall of the Iron Curtain then was that the governments of these countries owned all the land, they owned all the capital. That was the communist idea, was that the government would own all the means of production, including land, equipment, machines, capital, and so on. So one of the issues was, how do we go about changing that and privatizing it?
The way they did it was by renting or auctioning off land to people with close ties to the government.
So have you ever wondered where all these oligarchs come from? These were the smart guys that went around and they bought up all of these certificates. And so you end up with a small number of oligarchs owning large amounts of farmland. Then they will be eligible to get certain subsidies from the European Union.
Hungary's Prime Minister Viktor Orban auctioned off state-owned land to close friends and allies who raked in millions.
Mr. Orban has created a purely state agency with his people who are loyal to him. And of course, they make sure that access to land and access to direct payments are only granted to those people who are also loyal to the Hungarian Prime Minister.
And in the Czech Republic, Andrej Babiš, the serving prime minister of the country and a billionaire with an agriculture business empire that received millions worth of farming subsidies, currently faces a legal battle over alleged conflicts of interest and how he wielded political influence over the allocation of the funds.
the Czech Prime Minister is one of the biggest landowners, not only in the Czech Republic, but all over the European Union. And he has received, for example, in 2017, at least 65 million euros.
Those money were also used not only for agriculture, but also to support his entry to politics. And the money that were generated by his companies also helped him to buy the media in Czech Republic.
Především pan Babiš využívá peníze, které jsou určené pro rozvoj České republiky a pro občany České republiky takovým způsobem, že je to především pro jeho firmy a krade budoucnost dětem této země.
When farmers complained about this corruption, they were intimidated into silence by local officials.
A few days after the offer went public, the mayor of Felschut showed me from his car all the land that would be his, and he advised me not to apply.
It's 80% of the subsidies in the hands of roughly 20%, but nevertheless, even here, the Commission makes it very difficult to have a proper, transparent overview who is actually the final beneficiary.
CAP funds support approximately 7 million beneficiaries, but records of who exactly the benefactors are is only partially available. A murky system that leaves many wondering where subsidies really end up. One thing is clear, the people with the most land get most of the cash, meaning CAP is actually harming small farms by favoring the biggest farming conglomerates.
If the main purpose of the common agricultural policy today is to support agricultural incomes, then it looks strange indeed that it mostly benefits farms or corporations that don't have an income problem. That is a problem in the justification, and there are regular attempts to reduce that.
Meanwhile, EU policymakers are currently attempting to negotiate the next round of CAP funds, stamping out corruption as well as making agriculture more sustainable and eco-friendly are top priorities. But talks have already broken down once, and transparency will remain an issue.
We need a change in the regulation. The Commission has now, in the last audit report, has clearly stated that there is a conflict of interest. So there would be an opportunity for the Commission to act and to change this regulation, to finally say, okay, if the money ends up in the pocket of Mr. Babiš, we would suspend the payments, but that step hasn't happened.